International students who are studying at American universities on visas will have to leave the country if their classes are entirely online this fall. The announcement was made earlier this week and could result in a big blow to colleges' bottom lines, among other things, Robert Frank. But it's just disruptive. I'm hearing anecdotally about this from my daughter and a lot of people that she knows. This is a major issue. Do people know that? It's not just money. It's people's lives.
It's absolutely people's lives. And you're right. So much turmoil here. Colleges and universities scrambling this week to keep their international students after immigration announced plans to revoke those visas for students taking online courses. So here's what the decision was. ICE saying that overseas students who attend schools offering only online classes in the fall, like Harvard, must leave the country or transfer to a school with regular in-person classes. Now, students with visas who are not yet in the U.S. will also be barred from entering if their school is offering only online classes. Now, there are more than 1 million foreign college students in the U.S. who account for 15 to 20% of enrollment at many universities and an even larger share of tuition, since they pay full fare and spend $45 billion a year just on school costs. Now, Harvard President Larry Bacow calling the decision a blunt, one-size-fits-all approach to a complex problem. Columbia President Lee Bollinger calling it destructive and indefensible. Now, under the rules, if the course load is not entirely online, students can stay. So students at the University of Washington yesterday launching a petition to create a one-credit in-person course with only one meeting a quarter and excused absences to get around that rule. They already have 14,000 signatures there. But another issue here is a lot of these students who are in the U.S. who are now forced to go home can't go home because of travel restrictions.
Yeah, I was going to ask the same thing, not knowing about this petition these other students created. Why wouldn't the schools just set something up like a one-on-one in-person independent study that these students in particular are there for? I mean, it seems like that would satisfy the requirements by ICE.
Yeah, and that's what a lot of schools are doing. So, you know, we had Harvard saying we're going all online. What they may do is go, quote, hybrid, which many schools are doing, which is they're having some online courses and some in person. And the issue there is there are some people who are going to hybrid schools, but still were blocked out of any in-person classes. So you had U.S. students yesterday giving up their slots in in-person classes to the overseas students so they could stay in school.
Hey, Robert, we keep hearing the argument why this shouldn't happen. Can you make the argument why ICE did what it did?
Well, ICE's argument is that they're reverting back to the pre-COVID rule, which stated that overseas students couldn't get a visa if they were attending online-only classes. That was aimed at preventing fraud, I guess, a lot of these online universities. But there are some who think that the administration's real goal is to perhaps force colleges to further open in the fall and have more in-person classes. And perhaps also one other agenda here might be to get more of those slots for U.S. students and further restrict the amount of overseas students coming to the U.S. But we just don't know.